Individuals who have done incredibly well with their businesses. As an entrepreneur, I know how difficult it is to run a business in this environment. But to have CEOs and their staff under one roof who have made an impact in the Nigerian economy, it is a fantastic honor. You're most welcome. To kick off this event, I will invite the CEO of BusinessDay to give us a welcome address. Please round of applause, everybody.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I take a great honor and delight in welcoming you on behalf of BusinessDay to tonight's dinner. I'm particularly honored by the presence of my good friend Oscar, who has been gracious enough to be with us this evening. My role this evening is a very simple one, and that is to offer you a warm welcome. But in doing that, I'd like, if you permit me, to speak to the rationale of this award in the hope that we can provide a proper context. The top 25 CEOs award is the result of an annual work done by the BusinessDay Research and Intelligence Unit. And that work has sought to focus on chief executive officers of listed companies that have attracted to their companies and to their stock positive interest in the preceding year. The maiden edition was in 2013, and that ranked companies and their performance in the 2012 financial year. In 2013, the major parameter that we adopted for ranking and selecting top CEOs was simply that of share price appreciation. For the 2014 edition, we have improved somewhat by including as part of the indices for selection, profit after tax performance as well. We are quite aware as a business and financial newspaper that there is a correlation, not always, but most of the time, a correlation between the level of profit after tax and the growth in profit after tax, and of course, contribution to the Federal Treasury by way of tax payment. And so, this is not just to salute you for the work that you've done in terms of improving the bottom line of your companies. It is also to acknowledge your work as very diligent and important stakeholders in the Nigerian economy. Paying tax, growing wealth, and of course creating employment in a country where we need jobs so very badly. All the awardees this evening have had a significant upward movement in their share price, and as I said earlier, also growth in their profit after tax for the 2013 financial year. And it's also interesting to note that the top 25 CEOs have also been associated with contributing 68% of the gains in market capitalization in the course of 2013. So that's quite significant. If you need figures, these CEOs and their companies together have added 2.88 trillion out of the increase in capitalization of 4.25 trillion in the period under review. And consequently, they ensured in the course of the year that their share price outperformed the all-share index of the exchange, which closed the year up 47%. The CEO of Dangote Cement, I haven't seen him here today, worked with his team, and they are listed at the very top, of course, given the size of their capitalization and the size of their operation as well. The increase in terms of shareholders' value for the company is listed at 1.55 trillion in 2013. Next to him is a good friend, Danish, the CEO of Nestle PLC, and of course, Joe, our friend from Lafarge. But all together, what we find looking at these figures is a common trend. Operations expanding, profitability rising, share price appreciation, and as I said earlier, you couldn't have all that happen without more cash dropping into the national treasury. Ladies and gentlemen, we are at Business Day very honored that you've all, despite your very busy schedules, joined us here this evening. We expect that in the course of the following years, that this award will get bigger, and we also expect that the parameters will expand And hopefully, we will be seeking a different venue when we meet this time next year. As I said earlier, my role is very simple, and I think I have tried to do justice to it. We have awards to be given, we have dinner to be consumed. I think all that is left for me to say is once again to welcome you warmly and to hope that with us you will have a great night today. Thank you very much.
Mr. Frank, well, before we go into the dinner, I know everybody is looking forward to that. I would like to invite Mr. Aoyama Otsuka, who is the CEO of Nigerian Stock Exchange, to give the keynote address. Please, a round of applause.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, captains of industry, it gives me great pleasure to make these remarks at the BusinessDay Top 25 CEO Award 2014. But before I do that, I must say that Frank has said everything I wanted to say. So. It is interesting and encouraging to note that this event is geared towards celebrating outstanding chief executive officers of companies listed on the Nigerian Stock Exchange who aroused positive interest in the Nigerian capital markets over the last year. The maiden edition of these awards came up last year for the activities that materialized on the floor of the Nigerian Stock Exchange in 2012 fiscal year, with the principal parameter adopted for selecting the top CEOs being share price appreciation of their organizations. The organizers of this event have made it clear that this year's edition has been augmented in a progressive way, such that the growth rate in profit after tax of the latest quarterly results in 2013 were considered in addition to the share price appreciation. And Frank has given you a lot of detail on that, so I won't bore you with that. The 34th president of the U.S., General Dwight Eisenhower, once said that the supreme quality of leadership is integrity. At the exchange, one of our key watchwords is integrity. The good news about embracing corporate integrity into business is that research has shown over time that high integrity companies always eventually outperform low integrity companies by nearly 300%. That is, the total return to shareholders actually grows by about 286% according to Watson Watts study. At the NSE, we've geared up our efforts of ingraining corporate integrity into the fabric of our listed companies through the establishment of a corporate governance rating system. To achieve this, we entered into a partnership with the Convention on Business Integrity to develop a corporate governance rating system for listed companies in Nigeria that will empower people, their transactions, systems, and institutions. External assurance will be provided by the Humboldt Vivienne School of Governance in Berlin. We want to make sure that there's no if, but, and, that this is really what it is. And the companies that are going through the pilot program will tell you that it is a very detailed program. And once we've completed the pilot program, we'll extend it to all of our listed companies. The corporate governance rating system will deliver data and information that the NSE would rely on to build a corporate governance index after ranking listed companies based on the quality of their corporate integrity, corporate compliance, understanding of fiduciary responsibilities by their directors, and their corporate reputation as indicated by the ratings. we are instituting this system for listed companies in Nigeria as a way of redressing the perceived inadequate disclosures, manipulation, poor business environment, and corporate governance in Nigerian companies. Listed companies must always lead the way. The NSC continues to place corporate governance as one of its critical fundamentals for ensuring a healthy investment environment and maximizing investor returns. The creation of the Corporate Governance Index is in line with the exchange's commitment to promoting firm and fair corporate governance regime for sustainable growth of the nation's capital market. We intend to establish a premium board once we've bedded down the rating system. For a company to qualify for the premium board, it must qualify for the main board of the exchange and must be eligible to be included in the Corporate Governance Index and have a minimum capitalization of $1 billion. Without taking any more of your time, I will close with a mantra that good is the enemy of great. We congratulate the awardees for having all done a very good job with their performance over the last year and implore you to strive for greatness over the next year. I wish you a wonderful evening. Thank you very much.
For being part of this event, which is the award, and we're going to break it up, and you'll do me the honor of giving the first set. The awardees for this year's 2014-25 top CEOs, put together by BusinessDay Research and Intelligence Unit, collectively added 2.8 trillion out of the 4.25 trillion increases in market capitalization in 2013. Consequently, they ensured that their company's share prices outperformed the ASI of the NCA. Are we right?
Yes. Yes.
Excellent. Which closed the year at 47%. Put differently, their contributions amounted to 58%. Of the nation's budget in 2013. So I believe that, round of applause please. I believe that this is a fantastic stage for this award, and I also thank BusinessDay for thinking to put it all together. In no particular order, nobody came first, nobody came last. But I will just start with African Prudential, Mr. Peter. CEO, UBA Capital, Mr. Oluwatoyin Sanu. Mrs. Oh, my apologies. Well, now that's pretty number one. Congratulations, madam. Okay, to be safe, I won't give any tickets anymore. Okay, CEO, Custodian and Allied Insurance, Oluwale Oshin. Thank you for reading, UK. He is a British Chevalier Scholar, Executive Master of Business Administration, degree from the IESE Business School, University of Navarra, Barcelona, Spain, and a Bachelor of Science BSc degree in Finance from the Enugu State University of Technology, Enugu State, Nigeria, where he graduated as the department's best student. Mr. Okuda is an associate member of the Chartered Institute of Bankers of Nigeria, and is an international fixed income and derivatives certified professional. Once again, congratulations, sir. Round of applause. Thank you. Mrs. Oluwatoyin Sani was appointed the CEO of UBA Capital after her successful tenure as the CEO UBA Trustees Limited, a subsidiary of UBA Capital PLC and a market leader in the trustees business. Her ingenuity saw UBA Capital's share price increased by 78% in 2013. Thereby adding 3.2 billion naira to shareholders' wealth in the same year. Gross revenue for 2013 rose by 214% to 4.57 billion naira from 1.34 billion naira. For the year 2013, recorded a 24% increase, moving from 1.42 billion naira in December 2012 to 1.76 billion naira by 2013 year end. I have to say something, right? If you don't know your numbers, you can't be in this room as a top 25. Toyin holds a master's degree, LLM honors, from the University of Lagos, as well as the professional qualifications of the ICSA UK and the Chartered Institute of Stockbrokers, CIS Nigeria. She was a council member of the Institute of Chartered Secretaries and Administrators Nigeria, a fellow and vice president of the Association of Pensions Funds of Nigeria, APFN, an associate of the Institute of Directors Nigeria, and president of the Association of Corporate Trustees Nigeria. Toyin has served on various committees and boards, including the National Bond Steering Committee, the West African Capital Markets Integration Technical Committee, and as chairperson of the custodian of the custody subcommittee of the capital market. Congratulations, madam. Mr. Oluwole Oshin. He has over 26 years' experience in insurance underwriting claims, marketing, and investments. He was the past chairman of the Nigerian Insurance Association, former council member of the West African Insurance Institute, a member of the Council of the West African Insurance Companies Association. In 2013, he grew shareholders' wealth by 4.06 billion naira. He was able to achieve this due to the efficacy of his decisions. Custodian and Allied's share price appreciated by 60% in 2013, moving from 1.39 billion to 2.08 billion naira. Profit after tax 2013 increased by 152% to 3.6 billion naira, compared with 1.43 billion naira realized in comparable period 2012. Wole is the founder and managing director of the company. Having graduated from the University of Lagos with a BSc in Natural Science, Wole at various times worked at the National Insurance Corporation of Nigeria, NICON, Femi Johnson & Company Limited Insurance Brokers, and Crusaders Insurance PLC, from where he left to found Custodian in 1994. He is a fellow of the Chartered Insurance Institute of Nigeria, and an associate of the International Insurance Society, IIS New York, the elite society of insurance companies worldwide. He serves on the board of several companies and was on the presidential committee that set up the reforms in the pension industry. Congratulations, sir. Shinarish Gordon, to please come up and pick up his award. Mr. Gordon became the managing director of Nestle Nigeria PLC after his predecessor retired in June 2013. He has worked in several countries and in different capacities, some of which include store manager Luciano Men's Fashion Store, South Africa sales and marketing manager Universal Lace and Fabric Mills, Limited Durban, South Africa, Business Development Manager, Universal Print Group, Durban, South Africa, Category Channel Development Manager, Nestle SA, Southern Africa Region, Business Executive Manager, Dairy Business Unit, Nestle SA, Southern Africa Region, Group Channel Category Sales Development Head, Nestle Malaysia, Group Sales Director, Nestle SA, Limited Southern Africa Region. In 2013, Nestle's share price rose by 71% to 1,200 naira up from 700 naira from the beginning of the year. He was able to add 396 billion naira to shareholders' wealth for 2013, trended up to 22.3 billion naira up from 21 billion naira in the same period in 2012. The company has announced 24 naira as dividend per share for the year ended December 31st, 2013. Congratulations, sir. And I must say, Nestle was one of those stocks that never gave most people high blood pressure. When you look at the newspaper, you go straight to Nestle and you're like, okay, we're still on it. That's great. Congrats, sir. To say he's a award. Mr. Sunil is an aggressive, dynamic, self-motivated, hands-on leader with a high level of integrity and an eye for details. His resume is filled with high-profile accomplishments in market development and distribution and supply chain management. This also includes over 30 years in promotion of consumable and durable products with responsibility for profit center operations and management of field sales personnel. He has demonstrated high ability with a track record of success in Asia and Africa. Quarter 3 unaudited results ended December 31st, 2013 show that gross revenue rose by 23%. To 54.9 billion naira, up from 44.7 billion naira in comparable period in 2012. Profit after tax stood at 3.92 billion naira, up from 1.39 billion naira in comparable period. In addition, 7UP share price gained 70% as it rose from 42 naira to close the year at 71.4 naira. Fantastic. Sunil's areas of specialty include competitive analysis, strategic planning, team building, leader supply chain management, new launches, and operations. Congratulations, sir. I win your award. To invite Mr. Olatunde Olanipeku, who is representing Dr. Fidelis Aiba of Victor Healthcare PLC. Please come up to receive your award. Okay. Fidelis Aiba established Victor Healthcare in 1995 after working in various capacities in a number of organizations, including Citibank Limited. He is a pioneer chief executive officer at Bitson Healthcare Limited. Bitson's share price appreciated by 163% in 2013 as it moved from 1.08 naira in January to 2.79 naira by December of the same year. In essence, he improved shareholders' wealth by 2.57 billion naira. Aiba graduated from the Mainland Institute of Technology in 1976 with a diploma in civil engineering. He obtained advanced diploma in business administration from the University of Lagos in 1999. He is an associate of the Chartered Institute of Administration and also a member of the Nigerian Institute of Management. Congratulations, sir, on behalf of BusinessDay's. Mr. Adeniji, C, CEO National Salt. Please, sir, could you come for your award? Thank you. With a round of applause for their coming. We've had all the billions flying around. It's not easy to return shareholders' investment. Mr. Danny J. is the Managing Director of NASCOM. He has held that post since March 2007. Under his stewardship, NASCOM's share price rose by 87% from January to December 2013, from 8.38 to 14.99 billion naira. That translates to a gain of 17.5 billion naira, which is what he added to shareholders' wealth in 2013. Also, available financial figures show that quarter three increased by a percentage point from 2.04 billion naira in comparable period in 2012 to 2.06 billion naira in 2013. Mr. Adeniji is a chartered accountant. Before joining NASCOM, Adeniji had a successful career for 16 years within the UACN Unilever Group in different areas covering treasury, management. And thank you very much. Yes, I am aware, very grateful for your support. Registrars PLC. Mr. Peter is an astute investment banker with over 23 years of industry experience in the Nigerian capital market. 2013, financial year 13, financials show 79% growth in gross revenue. It rose to 1.85 billion naira from 1.03 billion naira in comparable period 2012. In addition, the company's share price traded up by 108%, moving from 50 kobo in January to 3 naira 32 kobo by December 2013. Peter holds a Bachelor of Science degree in Banking and Finance. In addition, he has a Master's degree in Business Administration with bias for marketing from Obafemi Awolowo University, Ile-Ife. A round of applause for him. Congratulations, sir. To my remaining awardees, I would like to invite Mr. Joseph Hudson, CEO of Lafarge, to receive his award. Mr. Joseph Hudson has held various positions spanning over 15 years at Lafarge Waco before he was appointed into the board of the company on the 16th of March 2011. He is currently the managing director and chief executive officer of the company. Prior to that, he was in charge of human resources and organization in Uganda. He went to the USA in 2004 to set up a North and South American satellite of the Lafarge University, a global development initiative for executives. He returned to Africa in 2009 as the regional vice president for Sub-Saharan Africa. Revenue as at quarter four 2013 rose by 12.3% to 98.798 billion naira up from 87.965 billion naira in comparable period in 2012. Total comprehensive income also increased by 94% from 14.7 billion naira in same period in 2012. To 28.26 billion naira in 2013. In addition, Lafarge share price jumped up by 94%, rising from 57.50 in January 2013 to 11.115 naira as at December 31st, 2013. With that, Hudson was able to add 172.6 billion naira to shareholders' wealth in 2013. Hudson is a Chartered Fellow of the Institute of Personnel and Development, FCIPD UK. He holds an honors degree from Exeter University, United Kingdom. He has represented England universities at rugby competitions. Congratulations, sir. I would like to invite Mr. Femi Oyetunji, CEO of Continental Insurance, to receive his award. Thank you. Dr. Femi Oyetunji is an astute manager with many years of industry experience. He grew Continental Re's share price by 62% in 2013. That translates to 4.56 billion naira gains for shareholders. The company's latest results indicate that PAT rose by 9% to 1.32 billion naira, up from 1.24 billion naira. He holds a PhD in statistics from the University of Manchester Institute of Science and Technology in the United Kingdom, and MSc in statistics from Imperial College in London, and a BSc First Class Honours degree in Statistics and Operational Research from the University of Manchester Institute of Science and Technology. He is a fellow of the Institute of Actuaries in the UK and has attended several management development programs locally and overseas. Sir, I think Unilag is missing one of their professors. Congratulations, sir. I would like to invite Mr. Julius Omodayo. Should I try it? Let me just say Mr. Julius. So please come and represent Mr. Aki Femiwa. Yes, for his award. Chief Executive Officer of Forte Oil PLC is responsible for the overall strategic direction for the business and the subsidiaries. Aki is a seasoned and experienced international petroleum products trader with focus on oil and oil products futures, swaps and derivatives, trading responsibilities. In 2013, he grew shareholders' wealth by 97 billion naira in 2013. In addition, the company's share price skyrocketed by 1,165%, moving from 7.73 naira from January to 97.75 by December. That deserves a whole I think that you are an alumnus of the Sage Business School, University of Oxford, United Kingdom. He also holds a BSc Honours degree in Mechanical Engineering from the University of Ibadan and a Master of Business Administration Information Technology from the University of Lincolnshire and Humberside, United Kingdom. Aki has also attended various global leadership courses and seminars, including that of the Wharton Business School, University of Pennsylvania. Congratulations, sir. And the last, but not least for this evening, I would like to invite Abdullahi Sule, CEO of Dangote. Congratulations, sir. Please, I would like all the awardees to please come and join us here for a group photograph with your awards.
gentlemen, I would like to thank you so very much for choosing to spend a good part of your evening with us today. We have thoroughly enjoyed your company, and it has been our delight to be associated with your company. In the welcome remarks that I made, I alluded to the significant contribution that you are leading your team at your various organizations to deliver both to shareholders and to the economy at large. As we depart this evening, I just want you to know and to feel confident that the work that you do, not only is it known, it is also appreciated. And I'm so glad that we've had all of the proceedings this evening, Oscar Onyema joining us. I have absolutely no doubt from what I see as a journalist and from discussions that I have with him and his colleagues at the exchange that the best days are ahead for the Nigerian economy and indeed for the Nigerian shareholders. We thank you all for your support and we congratulate you for the excellence that you signify in the little oases of sanity where you work. It's our pleasure to have you and we look forward to having you again next year. Thank you very much and good night.